And here comes this Jay-Z Knight character, and she just kept staring at those pyramids, and she didn't want to put one of those on. You know, I mean, there was beneath her dignity. I could tell that. And there was something inside of me said she's going to get one of these things, and she got it, and she wore it, and you saw what happened. Another time we had them at UCLA. I was talking last week about that little child, Stan Alms, who went total remission from epilepsy wearing the pyramid.
Yeah.
Well, during that same group up there at Orchid Union, we put him on the in the college classes. We had the kids wearing in college, you know, in Santa Barbara, sure. University of California, wearing the pyramids. And their grade point averages went up 1 point in the classes that wore the pyramids from semester.
That's not surprising.
Yeah, at least
that's
weird.
According to, you know, about psychicism.
Yeah.
And that, concerning numbers, like, let's say, could somebody wearing these pyramids pick out numbers at the casino and,
Well, you know, I'll tell you what happens in Las Vegas. It's funny you should mention that. We used to test the power of the pyramid over there. The MGM Grand was one of our favorite places. If we would put the pyridome, see, we have different levels of pyramid energy. They're different, depending on the orgone plating levels, depending on, depends on the energy.
Yeah.
And what psychic energy is you know, your aura is generating itself out, around the body. We'll get into auras more in the later things, but your aura frequency goes out. Now, if you develop a really powerful aura, it will affect other people's auras. When that affects them, it will cause them to turn around and look at you or be sensitive to you, whereas they might not be tuned into you because people can detect these subtle aura fields.
Yeah.
For example, if you have a magnet and you bring it near a piece of metal, that piece of metal becomes magnetized. The same thing with a human aura. So what we would do is the lower powered pyramids, like the little pyridome, which is a steel-based pyramid, we could, two or three of us would put the gold pyridome on our heads. We'd walk in the MGM Grand Hotel, and that was before it burned down now, the old big room over there.
Right.
That was our testing area. We'd walk in there, and we would clear a swath of gamblers probably 50 or 60 feet wide as we walked down through the center of the gambling rooms. They would stare at us from 50 to 60 foot wide swath. We put the radome on, which is silver, at another time when we developed that. We'd go over there every 4 months at different pyramids, and we would clear like 100, 150 foot swaths because we knew the energy was higher. So as you walk down the room, people from 150 feet would stop whatever they're doing and just literally stare at you. And then when we developed the power dome, which is the most powerful pyramid, and put that on your head, you walk in the MGM Grand, the whole place would stare at you. And we did a lot of tests with dowsers, and we found that the field varied on the individuals depending on which pyramid that we wore on our head, because we had a lot of dowsers to detect pretty much how far out the electromagnetic aura of a human is extended by different pyramids. As far as helping your gambling abilities, gambling is a form of intuition. I've got friends that are gamblers. They don't do it for a living. They do it for fun.
Yep.
But because they're wealthy and they don't really care whether they win or lose, it makes them free of that energy, that negative psychic energy that hovers around the gambling table.
I see what you're saying.
So they'll usually wear the receptor because it's not as conspicuous as the pyramid on their head. But what happens is it allows them to subconsciously analyze what, say, a roulette wheel is doing when you go by it.
Mm-hmm.
And I've seen them increase their winnings by wearing the pyramids many times over there. The first time we ever wore pyramids to Las Vegas, we got there, and that was back when the old Landmark Hotel was still there. It was many years ago in the 70s. There's three or four of us drove in to Las Vegas. All we did was drive in. I had a Lincoln Continental at the time, a nice car. I was wearing, you know, like a suit, but I had a pyramid on my head. I drove into town, went into the Landmark Hotel, checked in, and went to my room. 20 minutes later, on my first visit wearing a pyramid in Las Vegas, the sheriff called me up and said, well, I knew who we were and what we wanted. And I explained to him that I was Dr. Bell. We were from Laguna Beach. We were wearing pyramids because we were in the meditation, and we were on our way over to the convention center because we had a convention there, and our rep, Frank Berta, who's our Las Vegas rep, was waiting for us. That made the sheriff very happy. But the energy is so great on these things that this is what happens. I mean, it attracts attention. But at the same time, over the years, wearing a pyramid in public, For example, I was in the Old World restaurant one time with my wife in Hollywood.
Right.
We sat down there, and next to us were two people, and we had our pyramids on, and they started a conversation. And the guy's name was Henry Coleman and his girlfriend. He bought the pyramids right off our head, and then we became friends, and he was the executive producer for Love Boat. So as a result of that, he wanted me to become an actor on Love Boat with a major role, but I was into this holistic thing and have time for it. Another time I was at the Thoris restaurant. This 19-year-old girl came up. This is a number of years ago when I was younger, too. But 19-year-old girl came up and put her head on my lap and says, I want to know who you are. You're wearing a pyramid. And I says, what's your name? And she said, Michelle Pfeiffer. So I started dating Michelle Pfeiffer because I had a pyramid on my head. I mean, amazing things happen when you wear these things. I don't wear them in public like I used to, but I wouldn't be going down, caught dead going down the highway not wearing one. Because when you wear them, when you're driving your car, it increases your attention span and you don't get an accident. So basically, when you wear them, it's a whole other experience. But the only way I can describe it is to try it, you know.
What particular alloy or something do you use?
No, what it is we use two base metals, either steel or we use titanium.
Mm-hmm.
Now, titanium, because it's a precious metal, is more expensive than the steel one. And then we use Wilhelm Reich's orgone process, only instead of using wool and cotton, we use different metals, different rare metals, to amplify the orgone electricity. When I first met Ava Reich, who was Wilhelm Reich's daughter, it was at the Roosevelt Hotel back in about 1979. She's a medical doctor, and she was doing a medical conference. And we were doing a show with the National Health Federation down in the lower floors, and she was doing this a conference in the penthouse suite. And what happened was, one of my people walked in to her conference by mistake. She saw the pyramid on her head, and she said, there's an orgone-plated pyramid. She didn't even know what we had. She knew what it was. Okay, we got to take a break. We'll be right back. Remember, also, don't ever condemn some of these things without trying, because condemnation without experimentation is the height of ignorance, one of my teachers once taught me. So we had a lot of fun with the pyramids. And just to briefly go back over them so that people understand what we're talking about, some of the newer listeners, we have a 24-karat gold-plated steel pyramid that sells around $30. It's not very expensive. The only reason it's even that much is because gold prices have escalated from originally, when we started, it was $125 an ounce. Now I think it's $400-something an ounce. So that drives the price of our product up, but it's an amazing pyramid, the Pyridome. It puts you in the alpha state. And we developed it during the 70s when the American housewife was having a lot of problems with Valium. And that was the largest drug addiction at the time, whereas cocaine became the drug of the 80s of addiction. Valium was of the 70s. And then later on, we developed a copper-plated over gold pyramid on a steel base. It's called the Fire Dome, which stimulates the adrenal glands and gives you physical energy. And it's great for, you know, if you want to wash or wax your car and have energy the following evening. But, you know, do a lot of Saturday chores like I do and then still have energy for Saturday night. Pyramid is great because I just hate it when you do work real hard on Saturday and you have these plans for Saturday night, but suddenly you're so exhausted by 8 o'clock in the evening, you want to go to bed instead and go out and have a little fun. That's too bad, you know. And the Fire Dome helps alleviate that problem. And then we developed the Ray Dome later on using silver, which increases the mental and physical energy and your attention span. I do a lot of writing, for example, and those of you that have purchased my book, Death of Ignorance, which goes into a lot of this different, these subjects in great detail, if you look at the chapter I wrote in Oxygen, it's pretty long, in Pyramid Energy, it's a pretty long chapter, and I sat for 24 hours straight wearing a silver pyramid on my head and still had creative energies flowing in my body. Whereas the normal attention span for a writer, at least me, before I started wearing pyramids, and I used to write tech manuals for NASA, so I've been writing manuals and books all my life for different functions. I used to have about a 4-hour attention span. Once I started wearing the pyramid, it increased from 4 hours to about 16 or 17 hours. It's amazing to see that happen. And then we developed the titanium pyramids later on, and that was a bit of a nightmare because titanium is a wonder metal, but it's very hard to work with on a manufacturing level. And we had to use NASA plating tech, actually, to plate the titanium itself, because it's such a strong metal, but it's very light. We had to go back to a NASA place, NASA laboratory that does a lot of plating for the aerospace industry to get our plating done, which we currently go to now. But when you use titanium as a base and wear it on the head in a pyramid form, it's super light, but it has super conductivity, and the electricity levels of the brain are enhanced probably thousands of times. I know we've had a lot of universities test them, and they show a definite increase in endocrine activity, a definite increase in hormone activity at the receptor sites, and that's what we want in the brain, and a definite increase in mood elevation. And I think it's a lot safer to say that it's easier to do mood elevation with, say, a gold titanium product than a bunch of Prozac. So these are the kinds of things that we want.